I'm a little late to the game on this one, but as soon as I saw Flashback, I said, I have to talk about this. What is up, Flick fans? Welcome back to my channel. You guys know I like to talk about all the movies and shows on streaming. Flashback dropped on demand a few days ago, starring Dylan O'Brien. I knew nothing about this movie. I know nothing about what audiences or critics think because I've been busy this weekend, but we're going to talk about it right now. Frederick is living his best life until he starts having a horrific vision or visions of Cindy, a girl who vanished in high school. After reaching out to some friends with whom he used to take a mystery drug called Mercury with, Frederick realizes that the only way to stop the visions lies deep within his own memories, so he embarks on a terrifying mental odyssey to learn the truth. And let me tell you, I'm 20 minutes into this film thinking to myself, I don't really know what's going on right now, even though I understand the concept of this film, right? You can see shades of other films, from a Donnie Darko to a Matrix to, I believe the movie was called Bliss. It came out earlier this year. Wasn't blissful, not very good. But this film, on the other hand, does have more of a concrete story. And Dylan O'Brien being at the forefront and really focusing on this character, honing in, not worrying too much about the supporting characters in the outside world, or worlds, it really does give us a nice, interesting, slightly confusing character study that I walked away with thinking, did I enjoy that? It's one of those you have to sit on. It's not a casual watch, because you're going to watch this and you're going to have an abundance of questions. What reality was he really living in? We understand that Cindy is the key, played by Maika Monroe, and she is incredible in this film, along with Hannah Gross, along with Aaron Poole and Dylan O'Brien, who plays Fred and really carries this movie on his shoulders. But along with all of those really good performances, you have to have the screenplay and the script to match it. And while I don't know if it quite gets there, and a part of me wanted to not like this film. I hope that doesn't come across in the wrong way, because as I'm watching, I was so confused at points to where I was sitting back going, man, the writing here is really convoluted. But as the movie progressed, something about it sucked me in. And then, of course, at the end, you start to get your answers to a lot of those questions. So a lot of it does come full circle. And Flashback ended up being one of the most trippy, unexpected, mind-bending movies of the entire year that will inevitably be divisive, but I feel like this could have a cult following, and that Dylan O'Brien fan base, which, you know, maybe watching this movie going, I don't know what's going on, but I like Dylan O'Brien. That's going to be the case for a lot of people, but I feel like a lot of people are going to end up walking away really enjoying the experience. There was a film last year, I think it was last year, Synchronic, that involves a drug and time travel. Now, this film isn't specifically and strictly time travel. It goes deeper than that. If you're like an MCU fan, then you're going to start getting into the multiverses and all of this stuff. Yeah, the movie does kind of push those limits. But I mentioned the Donnie Darko comparison, and that is a film that, you know, the first time you watch it, it's so out there and weird. Now, it's set up much differently. And that movie has, you know, I think a better dark sense of humor about it, and it's really hard to make that Donnie Darko comparison. But there are shades of that in here, along with the idea of reality not being what it seems on the outside. Something more is at play here, and when taking this drug, you know, most people, pretty much everyone, doesn't have the memories of what it was like to be on this drug. But when we start to discover what this drug is actually doing to Dylan O'Brien's character of Frederick, well, that's when we start to get some answers to our questions. And Dylan O'Brien goes on this very metaphorical journey into his past. But is that really what we're getting? What seems to be flashbacks on the outside, and this is me trying not to do some major spoilers here, I'm trying to weave my way around that, becomes a very intimate and physical journey, and something that, you know, I mean, there are points in the movie when we get into the third act where there are a sequence of events, numerous things are happening, but they're all happening at the same time, and they conjoin together in such a way that makes me look at this movie and go, it's actually really well edited. But again, it's not a film that everyone's going to respond to in a positive way, and I completely understand. If you watched this and you were so confused and you hated every bit of it, I could probably see some valid criticisms there. I could. But for me, I started to become mesmerized. And after walking away thinking, okay, did it come together in the way? You know, I had to sit down, I had to think about it. And of course, you know, it's Monday getting this video out. The movie dropped on Friday. I finally come to realize that I really appreciate this film. Maybe I didn't get every answer I wanted to get, and that's probably going to be the case for a lot of people. But the attempt, and even the fact that it harkens back to all of these other movies that I mentioned before, yet kind of stands out, and it's just such a trippy journey. I like a movie like that. I also really like Dylan O'Brien, and I appreciate what this film was going for. So before I give you guys my score, thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoy these straight to on-demand reviews and you were looking forward to this movie, be sure to drop your thumbs up down below. Flashback features a somewhat frustrating narrative at first, but it slowly turns into one of the more fascinating experiences of the year. And again, Dylan O'Brien is excellent here. I'm actually going to go a 70% for this film. And part of that is just how intriguing this is, how it has resonated with me, and how I'm just so interested to see what the response is. I just pulled up Rotten Tomatoes for the first time, currently sitting right at 50%. Guess what? I'm going to add my review, and it's positive, so it'll be a little over that here in a few hours. But I need you guys in the comments down below. Appreciate you big time for watching, and I'll be seeing you very soon.